Hello students, so today we will discuss about multiport memories. So up to now we have discussed about the single port memory. Single port memory, it has just only one port for writing and reading operation. Single port memory performs only one access at a time, that is either we can do write operation or we can do read operation at a time. But multiple port memory has multiple ports, means multiple address lines, data lines and control lines. It can perform many operations at a time. For example, most commonly used multiport memory is a dual port memory. It can perform two operations at a time. Okay, it allows concurrent accesses. So it will avoid multiplexing and sequencing. Whatever the time required for multiplexing and sequencing and in single port memory, that will be overcome into the multiport memory. Okay, one scenario is that, so whenever a system, it will have a data producer, then that data will be stored into the memory and the stored data will be used by a consumer. So data producer, it will work at a different frequency, and data consumer, it will work at a different frequency, and hence we require memory to store the such a data. Okay, so in such a case we require multiport memories. Okay, but multiport memory requires more area than single port memory. Okay, for the same memory locations, it has separate ports which include separate address lines, data lines, control lines, and hence area required for it will be more. But it has only same storage locations for all the common locations. Okay, it has more cost, but its speed is more and it will overcome its drawback. So there will no possibility of loss of data in case of single port memory. There is a loss of data, but here in case of multiport memory there is no loss of data. In case of single port memory, data is ready at more than one inputs. Okay, and one input is waiting for that. So that one input is waiting, that data may be loose. Okay, such a case, so data will be lost, will be occurred, and so this will be overcome in case of multiport memory. Okay, so you can see the symbol of dual port memory. So symbol of dual port memory, here you can see, here it has a two ports. So the ports, it will includes address lines, data lines. Okay, this is data input line, data output line. Okay, this is address second, data input line second port, data output line second port, and these are the control inputs for port 1 and these are the control inputs for port 2. So control signals contains enable, write. Okay, these are the two signals we required, and one common signal is required, that is a clock. Okay, so it will do both access at the same time. Okay, so it will do read operation or write operations. But if the two write operations at the same memory location, or if the two read operations at the same memory location, or if one read and one write operation, it will be at the same memory location, then what is going to happen? Okay, so if both operations are write operations at the same memory location, then unpredictable data will be stored into the that particular address. because it has same addresses, address locations, and this port is going to be write into the same memory location. This port is write is into the same memory location. So the stored data will be the unpredictable data. Okay. As a multi-port memory, it will have same memory locations. So there are, suppose n memory locations. So all these n memory locations are common for this port and this port. Okay. And hence, if we do write operation at the same memory location from the two ports, then maybe there will be unpredictable data will be stored. If one operation is write and one operation is read at the same memory location, then also you will get the unpredictable data, okay, onto the output lines. Or if both operations are the read at the same memory location, if both operations are the read at the same memory location, then you will get the correct data, there will be no problem. But other two cases, that is, if both operations are the read operations, both operations are the write operations, and one write operation and one read operation, in that case also you will get the unpredictable data. Okay. So in multi-port memory, an additional circuit is used to handle this problem. It handles such a situation at same memory location. Okay, so when the access will be at a time, this circuit to handle this problem is called as a operator. Okay, so operator is used to handle such a problem. Okay, now we will discuss about one example, so that in your prescribed book, example number 5.7, develop a Verilog model of a dual port memory 4K into 16 bit flow through SRAM. Okay, such that one port allows a data to be written and other port is data to be one port allows a data to be written and read, while the other port only allows the data to be read. Means, if suppose there are two ports, so this is one port, it will allow read and write operations both, but this will allow only read operation. Okay, so then, so we how to write the dual the program for the dual port memory. Okay, so now you can see here the model name is a dual port SRAM. Okay, output port is, so we have to define input and outputs for port 1 and port 2. So for port 1, okay, so for port 1 output register, so it is 15 down to 0 and D out 1. So for port 1, inputs are 15 down to 0, data input 1, then input address inputs it is, so 11 down to 0, A1. Another inputs we require for port 1, that is input enable 1 and write 1. Okay, for port 2, we require, again we have to define, that is output register. Output register 15 down to 0, that is for D out 2. Okay, so then input is 11 down to 0, that is address A2. Actually here input is not required. Okay, input is not required because it is only read port. Okay, and here this is also not required, that is enable 2 will required only. Okay, so input enable to 11 down to 0 is not required, and this is also not required. Okay, so one more input is required for both ports, it is a clock. Okay, now you know that. So we have to write by using flow through SRAM. Okay. So you know that how to write the program for the flow through SRAM. In previous video, we have discussed about how to model the flow through SRAM. In the flow through SRAM, so it has by default the data will be moving towards the output port. Okay, and how many memory locations that array we have to define, and how much data bit that vector we have to define here. So here first thing is that register. So how much locations are there? 16 bit. Okay, each location having 16 bit data. So 15 down to 0. Data RAM, it is array and which is having the different locations, that is 4k memory locations. For 4k memory locations, it will have total memory locations varying from 0 to 4095. So this is array for the 4k memory. Okay, then next we have to proceed with the always block. Always at the positive edge. Now we have to define for read write port by using flow through SRAM. Okay, so if enable is equal to 1, if write is equal to 1, then we have to begin whatever the data that will be present onto the input data line, we have to store at the memory location. So therefore data RAM at the memory location, it will having contents that is on the data input 1. Okay, so the data on the data input line 1, that will be stored into the specified address location. As it is a flow through SRAM, we have to move this data to the output port also. So data input 1, that we have to move into the output port 1. Then we have to end it. If suppose else write is equal to, if write is not equal to 1, that is write is equal to 0, then else we have to do this, that is we have to perform read operation. So data RAM locations, whatever the address, whatever the data content into the address location, that will be stored in, that will be moved on to the output data line. Okay, so then we have to go towards next, that is read only memory. So in the read only memory, so always block is there, and for always block at positive edge of the clock, if enable input is equal to enable 2 is equal to 1, then directly we have to read the data, that is we have to read the data from the address locations. So address location is indicated by the address 2, that is for port 2. So content of the memory location from the address 2, indicated by the address 2, that will be moved on to the output line, and then we have to end. Okay, so this is about the dual port memory, how to write program or Verilog model program for the dual port memory. So dual port memory, it has two ports. So as per given example, the single port, first port, it is for both operations, that is a read write operation, and second port, it is for read operation. Okay, hence here, so this is for port 1, it is for read write operation and by using flow through SRAM, and second port is having only read operation, that is for read operation. Okay, by using flow through SRAM. In this way we can write the program. It is a very simple program, and definitely it will be for every example, every exam it is asked for exam. Okay, so then next, another type of multiport memory is FIFO memory. What is in FIFO? FIFO is first in first out buffer. Okay, so this is a special form of dual port memory. Okay, so this is another form of the dual port memory. Okay, again you can see here. So we have discussed one scenario. So that is one producer. So these are the sensors. Producers are nothing but the sensors. They are producing the data, and that data will be used by the consumer. But its speed of producing data is different, and consumer it will take the data with a different speed. Okay, so this speed may be more or may be less, and this speed will be more or less. So there will be the there will be no synchronization between these two. So to make the synchronization between these two, so data will be stored into the FIFO. So FIFO is the first in first out memory. So this is the use of FIFO memory. So that data will be stored into the FIFO, and then as per requirement of the consumer, so it will take the data from the memory itself. Okay, so now the most common way to build first in first out memory or FIFO is to use dual port memory in a circular buffer form. Okay, so we have to use dual port memory in circular buffer. Okay, so one port is accepting data from the source, and another port is reading data from the memory, and it will provide to the processing subsystem. Okay, so you can see here. So this is total memory location. This is memory. Okay, and one port it is doing only write operation, and another port is only doing read operation, and it is used in circular buffer form. Okay, what is meant by circular memory location or circular buffer form? That is, data is written to be data here is written in first memory location, then second memory location. At every time it is going on increasing one, and when it reaches to the last memory location, then again it will come to the zeroth memory location. Okay, this is first memory location, second memory location, and so on. So last memory location here, when it goes to the last memory location, again it will go to the zeroth memory location. Okay, when address counter reaches to the last location, it wraps to the zeroth memory location. Also in the same case, that is when it will read the addresses, when it will read the addresses from the zeroth memory location, and it will proceed for every cycle. When it reaches to the last memory location, again it wraps to zeroth memory location. Okay, if write address catches read address, okay, if write address catches the read address, then what will happen? Or read address catches the write address, then what will happen? Okay, so see here. Okay, if write address catches the read address, then we can say it is memory is full. Okay, both addresses here, read address and write address. So write address is going on writing the data. When a write address catches the read address, at that time memory will be full. And in other case, when read address catches the write address, okay, when read address, so this read address catches the write address, at that time so it will empty, memory will be empty. Okay, so we will see one more example related to this. So example of a FIFO, so from your book. next example will be there, and this example it is on FIFO. So design a FIFO to store up to 256 data atoms of 16 bit each using 256 memory location, and each memory location having 16 bits of the dual port SRAM for the data storage. The FIFO should provide status output as shown in the symbol figure 5.17. okay, this is figure 5.17. it will give indications. Okay, FIFO should provide the status output as shown in the symbol to indicate when the FIFO is empty and full. If FIFO is empty, it will give the signal, that is, it is a FIFO is empty, and if it is a full, it will give the signal. Okay, assume that the FIFO will not be read when it is empty, nor it will be written when it is full, and that the write and read ports share a common clock. So it will have common clock. So what is the condition? It is that we have to write, but it will not write when the memory is full, and when we do not read when the memory is empty. Okay, that is there. Okay, so then what is the solution for it? So we have to produce, we have to generate a data path for it. Okay, so how to write the data path for it? Okay, first in first out memory. Okay, so we can see the symbol of the FIFO memory. Symbol of the FIFO memory, it is like this. Okay, it has data write and data read. Okay, one port is writing only data, another port is reading only data. This has the control signals. Okay, and these are the indicators. Okay, but it don't have any address lines. Okay, it has counters on each port. It will have counter on each port, counter on each port, which increases with write enable and read enable inputs with clock, every clock. Okay, it has two indicators to indicate memory is full or empty. Okay, so now it will have counters to generate addresses, that is read address or write address. So this counter, you can see this counter, it is for generating read address, and this counter, it is generating write address. So this is 8 bit counter, this is also 8 bit counter, so it will generate 8 bit address, it will generate 8 bit address. That is, we require 256 memory locations. So 256 memory locations, we require 8 bit counter. Okay, so 2 raised to 8 will be 256. Okay, hence we require the 8 bit counter. Okay, and we require one equalizer, that is, when these addresses are equal, when these addresses are equal, that is when address read address catches write address, that we have to see that it is empty, or when write address catches read address, so we have to show that it will be memory is full. For that purpose, we require one equalizer. Okay, when we require the dual port static RAM, okay, synchronous static RAM, and for this synchronous static RAM, you will know that it will have this address, this is data input. So these are the control signal, write enable control signal, this is control signal for next port, that is a read port, that is a read enable control signal. Okay, so data will be out here and address for the read. Okay, so in this way the data path is circuited, or so it will be connected like this. For first counter, so input is the read enable. For second counter, input is the write enable. So this is a write enable. So for this write enable also required for the memory to write. Read enable is required for the this counter as well as the for another port, that is read port. Okay. And when there is a reset input, so this is a reset input, this is a reset input. When there is a reset input, the counters will be maintained equal to 0. Okay. Okay, now we can see that in this example, when write address catches the read address, FIPO is full. Okay, and when read address catches write, FIPO will be empty. It means that in both conditions, address and read address and write address is going to be equal, but only equality sign is not sufficient. Okay, because when the equal is there, then how it will get that memory is full or memory is empty? So for that purpose we require, how we can distinguish, we need to distinguish between these two cases. But how? So there is one solution for it, that is by using finite state machine. Okay, finite state machine, it will use two transitions, that is one is this is transition diagram for finite state machine, and first transition is emptying, so memory is emptying, and another transition, that is memory is filling. That is when there are two conditions will be there, so there is a not concurrent operations, that is write operations and read operation is a not concurrent operation. Okay, when no, okay, filling when write operation without concurrent read operation, at that time filling will be done. You can see here, so this signal and this signal, so there are the two control signals, that is write enable and read enable. If it is equal to 1 and this is equal to 0, means there is only one write operation, there is no read operation, means it will do only the write operation, it will not do only the read operation. So this is filling. And another case, emptying case, when read operation without concurrent write operation, that is here, that is write operation is equal to 0 and read operation is equal to 1, so it will only read, means it is going to be emptying the memory. Okay, so whenever the read and write operation, that conditions we can use for the when filling and equal, then it will be full, and when emptying and equal, then it will be empty. Okay, this condition we'll see. When it is going to be filled, and at that time it is memory, both addresses are equal, then we can see it is a full. When it is emptying and both addresses are equal, then we can say memory is empty. In this way we can solve this problem. Okay, this is about your FIPO control memory, that is FIPO memory, that is for given example. So this is about the data path of FIPO, and this is about the finite state machine of the FIPO. Okay, so in multiple, where the FIPO is used, multiple clock domains the FIPO will be used. Okay, need to resynchronize the data that transfers the clock domain, so that use resynchronizing register. So it will be used as a resynchronizing registers. But we have seen that is in producer and consumer, in that producer and consumer both are operating at different frequencies, So we need to resynchronize, and FIPO is used as a resynchronized register. Okay, so in this case it may overrun if sender having clock more faster than the receiver. Or so in this case we have to make FIPO smooth out differences in the data flow rates. Okay, latch cells inside the FIPO RAM written with the sender clock cycle. Okay, in producer and consumer it will be written, FIPO RAM will be written with the sender clock, and FIPO RAM will be read with the help of receiver clock. So that is different clock frequencies will be there. Okay, so in such a case first in first out memory will be used. Okay, that's all about today's video. Today we'll stop here. Okay.